Welcome to the Knox video training series. In this video, we'll introduce you to the features available in the Knox Guard console. Knox Guard is a cloud-based service designed for carriers, banks, mobile device retailers, and other organizations that want to protect their mobile devices from theft and financial risk. By providing tools to help administrators remotely manage, control, and if necessary, lock Samsung devices, Knox Guard can help companies quickly recover from lost revenue and prevent the gray market sale of devices whenever subscribers miss their payments. So if you're an organization that needs theft and asset protection for your devices, let's get started. Before you begin using Knox Guard, you'll need to create a Samsung account at samsungknox.com and apply for access to the Knox Guard console. This can be done by going to samsungknox.com, then selecting Products Knox Guard. On the Knox Guard page, scroll to the Get Started section, click Get a Free Trial, then accept the terms and conditions. Please note that if you are using either Knox Deployment Program or Knox Managed Service Provider, the same email address cannot be used for Knox Guard. After you apply for access, the Knox Guard widget will show a pending status. Once the Samsung Knox team approves your request, you'll get an email letting you know that access is granted. Once you have access, click the Knox Guard widget to launch the Knox Guard console. By default, you'll land on the Knox Guard dashboard. This page lets you quickly review important information about your managed devices, like which ones have upcoming payments due, which ones are locked due to delinquent payments, and which devices had unlisted SIM card attempts. The dashboard contains five key elements. Device status lets you quickly see which devices have upcoming payment reminders, and which ones have been locked down due to missed payments. License status lets you view the license expiry dates and remaining available seats for your Knox Guard managed devices. Device trends provides a graph to help visualize how many of your devices had payment reminders or were locked down during a specific time period. And license usage graphs out the number of licenses activated versus the number of devices used during a specific time period. Some Knox Guard administrators may also see unlisted SIM card attempts and API console link on their dashboard if it has been enabled. The Devices page provides a table view summary of every device uploaded by your Samsung approved resellers. From here, you can view details like the device activation date, reseller info, and relevant policies and notes by simply clicking on the IMEI or serial number in each row. If you wish to perform administrative tasks like managing policies, sending payment reminders, locking and unlocking devices, or viewing device logs, select one or more rows from the table and click Actions. A drop-down menu appears with a list of available options. Select any item from the list to perform that action. Policies are the core of Knox Guard usage, as they help define how and when devices get locked down, depending on the subscriber pay model or user account type. For postpaid subscription models or normal account types, subscribers will be locked out of their device if they don't pay. They will also receive messages with instructions on how to unlock their devices. For prepaid subscription models or pay-as-you-go account types, subscribers will receive reminder messages before their subscription ends and their device locks. Let's take a closer look at some of the policy configuration options available in Knox Guard. The Knox Guard Policies page provides the following options for administrators. Device lock is where you can set up the lock options for your managed devices. Locking a device disables all available functionality until payment is made, or when a Knox Guard admin decides to unlock it. In advanced controls, you can upload custom applications to your devices and configure devices to lock down whenever an unauthorized SIM card is detected. Messaging lets you customize the device blink interval and message text that gets sent to subscribers who become delinquent with their payments. In settings, you can customize your enrollment message, set up your end user license agreement, and customize the icon for all Knox Guard notifications. Note that device lock and messaging options differ slightly between normal and pay-as-you-go policy types. Let's move over to licenses. On the licenses page, you can add and manage Knox Guard licenses for your devices. These licenses are broken into two categories, trial and commercial. The trial license lets you get familiar with the console and test Knox Guard functionality for up to 3 months with a maximum of 30 devices. You can request a trial license by clicking Get License. The commercial license gives you full access to the Knox Guard console and all functionality for 3 years based on the number of devices you have. Once you purchase a license, click Enter License Key to activate it. Note that you have 12 months to activate your device after a license purchase. Once activated, each device will begin counting its 3-year license period the moment it connects to the Knox Guard server. Moving on to the resellers page, here you can add one or more Samsung-approved resellers so that they can upload devices directly to your account. In order to add a Samsung reseller, you will need to provide them with your Knox Guard customer ID and obtain their Knox reseller ID. Once a reseller is registered, you can configure Knox Guard to automatically approve all devices uploaded by that reseller, or for more control, you can manually approve each device yourself. Next, we'll take a look at administrators and roles. By default, a single super administrator login is created after you get access to Knox Guard. As the super admin, you can invite other users to be administrators of your Knox Guard console. To add other admins, you'll need to first create the proper role by going to the Roles tab and selecting Create Role. From there, you can define which functionalities your admins can and cannot access. After you define the role, go to the Administrators tab, then click Actions and select Invite to register additional admins to your console. Note that once you invite an administrator to your console, they cannot be invited as an admin to another Knox Guard console. If necessary, you can revoke an invite by selecting the admin's name and clicking Revoke Invitation. Let's move over to the activity log next. The activity log lets Knox Guard admins check what is happening in their console. You can see who made changes, when they made them, and what those changes were. If necessary, you can download a log of all your activity by clicking the Download Activity as CSV button. Finally, we'll explain the support page. On the support page, you'll find helpful links to our Knox Guard user guide, which covers each feature in great detail, as well as common questions and answers, and if enabled, an API integration guide to help you learn about automating Knox Guard processes. In the technical support field, you can access information on how to contact our support team for assistance. This concludes our tour of the Knox Guard console. For more information on Knox Guard or on getting started with other Knox services, please visit docs.samsungknox.com. Thank you for watching.